Os maias são excelentes astrônomos. Não é à toa que eles ganharam uma boa fama por conta disso. Assim como pelo calendário maia, que é um conhecimento tão incrível que ajuda tanto no autoconhecimento como no entendimento da criação do ser humano. Mas muitas vezes que a gente procura na internet, a gente encontra o termo astrologia maia, que é onde esses dois conceitos se misturam e é onde a informação começa a ser desviada. Nesse vídeo, eu falo com o guia espiritual maia, a Pabian Teo, que também é o autor do livro O Nascimento do Universo, onde ele esclarece esse conceito, que cria muita confusão, e ajuda vocês a chegarem na informação real e qual que é o verdadeiro foco dos maias.
Well, we Mayans, we practice astronomy. And it's not that difficult to understand. There's a basic point that is very pretty obvious. We don't have artificial irrigation systems. We depend on the cycles of nature. For us, nowadays it's a fashion to talk about this. For us, everything is interconnected. But for us, it has been during millennia. This is not new age discovery for us. When you depend on understanding nature, understanding the clouds, the wind, the movement of the stars, which is, let's say, the quantity of lightning in one night, how the thunder falls or connect the sky and the earth and the strength, you can begin little by little to read what is happening in nature. And at the same time, you can look at the stars and see which is the star, in which position is, which is this constellation. And also there are migrations of birds, the appearings of butterflies, the fireflies that announce you stuff. So there's always a way of reading the cosmos, the nature, the sky, the earth, as an open book for you to know and to understand patterns of dialogue in the nature. When you begin to do that, then you can predict also, and or not as in the Western world. In the Western world, the people try to modify to enter. We understand to go with the flow of nature. We don't pretend to be the owners. And we don't make any change. We go with the flow. So in the end, you ended up understanding the movement of the stars. And by the way, in the Mayan Highlands, there's you can see the Milky Way. You can see very brightly some of the stars, the positions of Venus. You can see the stars in a very clear way. And it's not that difficult. We interconnect the movements of the stars with the wind, with the butterflies, with the ants, with the spider. The spider is very important for us. And in that sense, we practice astronomy, but not astrology. We don't say that certain star is going to make you some influence or whatever. What we do is what I'm presenting now. There is a study, the study of pregnancy. As a difference between astrology from gravitatology is the basis. We based everything in the study of the conscious baby in a mother's womb. We based everything as a response of an already active consciousness that is shaped by the mother's experience. So when a person asked, like, why is my son so violent? Why he has this or that? Then you go to pregnancy to see which were those influences. And for example, for violence in a violent teenager, there must be always violence in the middle of the family, or that the mother was resenting something like that. It's an influence that shaped a consciousness. So we don't make stellar charts. We don't base anything on Greek histories. That is something that is not connected in any way to us. There's no Mayan astrology. There's Mayan astronomy and gravitatology, the study of the pregnancy. The most amazing thing that I would want to say to everybody who is open to understand this is that the Mayan calendar is the real key to understand the connections between the way in which you are created and the way in which now you respond to the world. And as I said, is a consciousness that is already shaped. There's also a bodily memory that receives the impact of conditions during pregnancy, and also a deep way of consciousness that is present in the baby since those moments, that is present in this time for every one of us, that is also leading from the background some of the stuff that we choose and decide. In this sense, the knowledge that we Mayans really have to present is a gravitatology, and we have to reject the idea of Mayan astrology. That is something that you can find by Googling it, about which is my destiny, which is my name. And sometimes what you find in the internet is just folklorical stuff like you are a flower, you are this, you are the other, but nobody told you the truth. And to be honest, especially with you, it would be a good exercise to go and see how you were created, which were the conditions. Was your mother okay? Was the father present? Was the father a good father? Were they okay with each other? Were they having economical problems? Because all of that is going to affect the consciousness of the baby. And it is a very good exercise to go back and to understand that you are the result of the way in which you were created. That is a very crucial, and I have never seen any sophisticated knowledge that talks about this, and so precise way of understanding. And I found it beautifully also because it's also an epistemology of the self. It's an epistemology of knowledge, epistemology of the Mayan calendar, and epistemology of consciousness, how consciousness arises and what are the properties of consciousness after birth, which is the role that this consciousness plays in you. Because sometimes we are so lost in life. It's like when people say, I don't know what I'm doing this. I cannot go away from this. I don't know. I always choose the same kind of persons. I always have this bad luck in my life and stuff like that. And it is not true. Just go back to your creation times. And the Mayan calendar is the most beautiful and sophisticated native knowledge to understand consciousness, the baby, and the self.